Greetings, I'm the Reverend Timothy Murphy, Senior Pastor and Teacher at Plymouth Congregational Church in Fort Wayne, Indiana. We'd so look forward to having a Boar's Head and Yule Log Festival, making plans for multiple months, and looking forward to having an in-person service. But with the continuation of the pandemic, and out of concern for everyone's safety, we just determined that simply wasn't possible this year. So what we're offering for you tonight is a virtual tribute video of the Boar's Head and Yule Log Festival. We hope to be able to have this in person in 2022, and we look forward to seeing you then where we can all celebrate that service in person again. Until that time, hope that you enjoy the following video. Blessings and peace. Here at Plymouth, we have four covenants that we affirm each week about who we are and what we're about in this world. First, we're an open and affirming congregation to our lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, and queer family members, friends, neighbors, strangers, anyone seeking a safe home in which to be part of a spiritual community. Second, we're a just peace congregation working for a world where no one is oppressed, marginalized, or exploited. Third, we promote earthwise stewardship and protecting our planet and from climate change and protecting it for the next seven generations and beyond. And fourth, we're a global mission church, intensely local, intentionally global, partnering with other organizations near and far in service.
Thank you. Greetings. I'm Kara Jarrigy, and on behalf of the entire Boar's Head and Yule Log production team, we welcome you. Once again, we find ourselves in a situation where we are unable to produce and present to you the annual Boar's Head and Yule Log Festival here at Plymouth Church. We invite you and your families to sit back and enjoy once again our virtual memory of the Boar's Head and Yule Log Festival. Happy holidays.
nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from woe and sin when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
In Bethlehem, in Jewry, this blessed babe was born.
Christmas. The Boar's Head Festival is one of the oldest festivals celebrated during the Christmas season. The wild boar was considered one of the most dangerous beasts in the forest in the feudal era in Europe, especially England. The boar became synonymous with evil, so the killing of a wild boar was something to celebrate. The first part of our festival is a recreation of that secular celebration with the presentation of the boar's head to the Lord of a manor and then the festivities and merriment that follow. By 1340, the secular festival joined the Christmas celebration at Queen's College, Oxford, England. So the second part of the festival is our sacred story of the Nativity. The birth of Jesus is the light coming into our world and the conquering of goodness over evil demonstrated in the lighting of the Christ candle at the beginning of the festival that lasts throughout the festival and then is carried out into the world. The Boar's Head Festival was first produced here at Plymouth Congregational Church 46 years ago in 1975 because of the foresight of five great talents. Howard Brown, producer, Wanda Pohl, costumer, Don Goss, props and staging, Joan Stanger, assistant direction, and Vincent E. Slater, who arranged and conducted all of the music for choir and orchestra. My name is Jim Schmidt, artistic director. Under normal circumstances, I would be welcoming 400 audience members on behalf of my co-directors, Kara Jarrighi and my maestro, Robert Nance, and the 300 cast, crew, choir, and orchestra members. 2020 is obviously not a normal year. We offer our prayers for everyone's health and safety. In place of our 46-year tradition, and because of an idea of Robert Nance and the technical and artistic talents of Eric Miller, we have a YouTube memory of the festival so that we might have some images, music, and past memories to remain part of our holiday traditions of Plymouth's Boar's Head and Yule Log Festival. We welcome you and begin the video with the traditional words, Maestro Nance, let the magic begin.
The courtly story, the coming of the Yule Sprite. Into the darkened church comes a tiny sprite carrying a lighted taper, symbolizing the coming of Jesus into the selfish world which awaits his advent. Slowly, through the darkness, the light moves to the altar where it is given to the church in the great Christ candle, which is present throughout the festival.
Thank you. Procession of the Beefeaters. The gong sounds the hour. The cadence of the drums and the heavy tread of the yeomen of the guard, traditional guardians of a king, falls on the ears like the march of history. Solemnly, they stand their watch of honor. The Boar's Head Procession. The trumpet sounds, the light grows, and the story unfolds quickly as singing companies enter bearing a boar's head, a plum pudding, and a mince pie. Since ancient times, the fierce wild boar has been a symbol of evil. Its presentation at the altar signifies the victory of the Christ child over sin. The plum pudding and mince pie suggest the richness and fullness of the gifts of God. For all those blessings, the Boar's Head Carol renders praise unto God. Nobility, guards, a huntsman, a cook, the players, the poor folk, many servers and small pages are among the diverse company that follows the slain boar to the altar. Members of the congregation are not only witnesses, but also participants, lifted out of themselves and their everyday world by joining in hymns of praise to Almighty God. As the boar's head is brought into the church, the entire congregation sings the refrain.
Vede cantico. In honor of the King of Bliss, which on this day to be served is in regimentia trio. Hence King became a helpless child. The sword bore death until it fell. This mighty deed for us was done. Therefore we sing in unison. The huntsman drew his power to harm, so death, which still appears so grim, has yielded all its power to him.
Masters in this hall.
Oh,
dancers. Young maidens of the court dance for the pleasure of the assembled guests. On this day, earth shall ring.
On this day, earth shall ring with the song children sing to the Lord Christ our King, born on earth to save us. Him the Father gave us.
Good King Wenceslas. As is tradition in this festival, before the merriment ends, the Lord of the Manor assumes the persona of the beloved Good King Wenceslas to convey a moral message to his people. He dons the Bohemian crown of the 10th century Saint Wenceslas, and he and his page sing of Christian ideals in daily life when good folk care for each other.
When a poor man came inside, every winter through,
then stand by me. If thou know'st it, telling yonder peasant who is he, where and what is dwelling.
Sir, he lives a goodly hands underneath the mountain, right against the forest fence by St. Agnes Fountain.
Bring me flesh and bring me wine, bring me pine logs hither. Thou and I will see him dine when we bear them thither.
Page and monarch, forth they went together. Through the moonbeams of the night and the bitter weather.
Sir, the night grows darker now, and the
mark my footsteps, good my page, tread thou in them boldly. Thou wilt find the winter's rage will freeze thy blood less coldly.
The Yule log procession, gayest and brightest of all medieval customs, was the bringing in of the Yule log. Gathered from the woods, it was brought ceremoniously to the hearth of the home and lighted from the embers of last year's fire, symbol of the rekindling of love, promise for the year ahead, and a prayer for God's keeping. Deck the halls. The waits and carolers come sharing the gladness of Christmas. Their exuberant gaiety and irrepressibly high spirits are the gifts of youth. I saw three ships.
I saw three ships.
the wassailers. The hour grows late. After much merriment and wassail, the court jester seeks a quiet spot to contemplate the events of the evening. He is joined by a lively group, which has more celebrating to do. The Christmas Story. Mary and Joseph approach the inn. The innkeeper gives the weary couple his last accommodation. The crude stable.
Thank you.
The apparition. In a starlit high pasture, a group of shepherds pass a long night playing their instruments and simple games. The trumpet sounds and the shepherds rise in alarm. The Angel Gabriel. Choir of Angels. Shepherds' chorus. In simple adoration, the shepherds summon each of us to worship, to see this thing which has come to pass. These are the simple folk of the earth. As the shepherds travel to Bethlehem, cherubs celebrate through dance the birth of the baby Jesus.
On the way to Bethlehem,
Hail to the Lord's anointed. The shepherds reach their destination and find the babe, Mary, and Joseph. Born in Bethlehem. An angel visits the stable in a moment frozen in time.
Thank you.
Noel. The shepherds mark the place of our Savior's birth. The Kings. In eastern splendor, the kings and their company follow the star of the east to their high destiny. These are the great of the world, rulers of people and affairs. Following in the steps of the shepherds, they go bearing gifts, seeking the Christ born to be the hope of the future.
The East.
let all mortal flesh. The court returns, drawn to a sacred place. Each has made an individual journey to this place. People from everywhere come and gaze in amazement at this miracle that has come to pass. The highest king and the lowliest shepherd are united. The young and the old walk together. God has come down to each of these persons, and each of them reaches up to God. All of us gathered here share the wonder which has come down through the centuries, even unto this particular night in this particular year. The drama of humankind's response to the great gift of God's Son has been enacted before you. After young and old, rich and poor, wise and simple, have offered their unique gifts to the Christ child on his birthday, all go forth to the glorious strains of Adeste Fidelis, as congregation and players join together in this song of joy and adoration.